안녕하세요. 단국대학교 치과대학 이준석입니다.
Greetings, I'm Professor 이준석 of 단국 University Dental School. Today I'm going to talk about taking impression on posterior implant. The procedure of impression taking in anterior and posterior area do not differ much. The only difference is the limitation in vertical space due to lack of mouth opening, and at times adjacent teeth with long clinical crown can be included. Could these affect the difference in procedure? Let's take a look. Today, I'm going to talk about the difference in taking impression for natural tooth and implants. And I'm going to look at the traits of abutment level and implant level impression taking. I'm going to compare the different impression taking methods. First, I'm going to talk about basic considerations. I'm going to look at the difference between impression taking in natural tooth and implants. In the case of a conventional prosthesis, abutment is prepped tooth in terms of impression taking. Even if the number of the tooth is the same, all patients have different form of tooth. Modification of tooth is done by the dentist, therefore there can be no same abutment. Regardless of whether it is a vital tooth or non-vital tooth, modification to tooth should not weaken the tooth, therefore there can be limitations in the amount of prep and modification. Depending on the position, it may look very different, and even in the same tooth, the finish line, the position and thickness may differ. You can see that clearly in the image. Therefore, the main issue in taking impression in conventional prosthesis, it is accurately replicating the tooth, and the subgingival margin needs to be registered as well. As for implants, prefabricated components are used. Impression coping or abutment pickup is used to take impression. Also, you can modify the abutment significantly, and except for when changing the abutment margin, the abutment form is uniform. The main issue in taking impression of the implant is whether the components can be connected accurately and have positional stability, as shown in the image. It does not matter even if the margin is slightly off, it's okay. In taking implant impression, to secure stability, rigid impression material is used, or blockout may be added to the procedure. Partial tray may also be needed. Let me talk about implant level impression taking. This can be divided into abutment level impression taking and implant level impression taking. Let's take a look at the implant level impression taking. This can largely be divided into pickup impression taking and transfer impression taking. This can be referred to as open tray technique and closed tray technique. Let's look at impression coping. First is pickup impression coping. There's hex and non-hex type. The height is 11 mm and 15 mm. It has 5 different diameter to fit different abutments, and there are 3 types of guide pin, 0mm, 5mm, and 9mm. In the posterior area, 9mm guide pin is rarely used, but if the adjacent tooth's crown length is long, it can be used. Next is transfer impression coping. It has hex and non-hex connection type. The height of impression coping is 11mm and 14mm. The long one is 1mm shorter than pickup impression coping. The diameter. There are 5 different types. Transfer impression coping gets a positional stability with notch and groove. The new bite impression coping. This is a new transfer impression coping. There's one where you use the gentle driver and the other one you use friction driver, and this has no driver hole on top. There's 3.5mm and 5.5mm. In the case of friction screw, it is 1.5mm longer, so there's a 5mm and 7mm height. Depending on gingival depths, there are 4 different types. This may be short, but by emphasizing the notch and groove, stability is secured. At times, a bite tray can be used. They are similar impression coping, but removing the impression body is completely different for both types. Let's look at the mechanism for removal for using these two impression coping. The only common factor is that it uses the elasticity of impression material. It is separated like this. As for pickup type, in the connection area between implant and impression coping, separation occurs. On the other hand, transfer coping, the separation occurs between impression coping and impression body. As shown in red, this is where the separation occurs, and there is a stark gap. Which do you think can be separated more easily? They are removed by the elasticity of impression body, and pickup type can be removed much easily. In other words, if the angles vary, transfer type can be harder to remove. In the case of transfer type, there's higher possibility of error, and if the angles differ, it requires more elasticity of the impression material, therefore a larger tray may be needed, and impression material with better elasticity may be required. At times, people get confused over pickup and transfer coping. When you take a pickup impression, people sometimes think that for positional stability, splinting is required. However, this is a method applied when using external type. US type allows for error. It is a slip fit type. The hex height is 0.7mm, so very short. It has clear platform. Passive fit is very important for positional stability. However, in the case of conical seal type, due to limitation caused by path, it can be inaccurate. In the case of internal type, it is not recommended to splint impression coping. Because of these traits, Pickup type has very high accuracy and is recommended in multiple cases. However, open tring needs to be formed, and if implants have been placed, a nicely transferred type can be preferred. If there's limitation in mouth opening, it can be difficult to use due to the guide pin. On the other hand, in the case of transfer impression coping, it uses ready-made tray, so it's very convenient. However, pickup type is more recommended for screw-retained prosthesis, and the accuracy of impression material can be affected by the angle or adjacent structure. As shown, when choosing impression coping, depending on healing abutment diameter, you can choose between 5 different options. And depending on vertical space, you can choose 11mm or 14mm. Or you can use 3.5mm bite impression coping. The proximity with adjacent structure and placement depths needs to be considered as well. This is a single case for number 36. Transfer coping was connected. Number 37 was mesially tilted, and you can see it is quite close with the impression coping. In this case, which would be more accurate, pickup or transfer impression coping? As for pickup type, it can be removed along with impression material, but transfer type, the impression material can tear or be deformed. Among transfer type, what would happen if we use bite impression coping? Which would cause a less deformation or tear on impression material between the transfer impression coping and bite impression coping? Due to the separation mechanism, there can be difference in accuracy of impression material. In this case, pickup type impression coping is recommended. Next, in the case where implant is placed too deep, in other words, if the gingival depth is deep, the portion where it is in connection with the impression material is too short, so positional stability goes down. In this case, pickup type impression coping needs to be used for accurate impression taking. Next, I'm going to talk about abutment level impression. We fully understand how to take impression in solid abutments. Indirect impression method is used, stock abutment is placed, impression coping and analog is used to fabricate cement retained prosthesis. After taking implant level impression, it needs to be reconnected with an oral cavity, and impression needs to be taken again at times. This is called direct impression method. If there is positional error when abutment is connected or when there is modification with an oral cavity, this is done. As shown in number 1, if the prosthesis is fabricated unlike what was anticipated, we need to take impression once again. As shown in number 2, if abutment was modified within oral cavity, impression needs to be taken again. Ideally, theoretically, taking impression once again within oral cavity can increase the accuracy of position. However, The implant has a deep sulcus. In the case of conical seal, emergence angle is very significant. Therefore, if the material goes in, it can be torn as the impression material is removed. Even if you use cord, it can be mixed with the impression material. In the below image, residual impression material can be seen in the inferior portion of the abutment. Also, the margin can become shorter. You can get margin that is shorter than the abutment if you look at the lower right image. Abutment level impression taking is accurate, but it can cause error. Therefore, precise attention is required. Let me summarize. Different types of impression taking can be used. However, it is important to choose the right impression coping, given the circumstance. When the inter-implant angle is large, a pickup coping type is recommended. Abutment level impression can lead to highly accurate prosthesis. However, the possibility of error also increases. Therefore, precise attention is required. Prosthesis with supragingival margin allows for easy fabrication of prosthesis and reduction in complications. Today, I talked about taking implant impression in the posterior area. Taking impression is essential in making accurate prosthesis. It reproduces oral cavity accurately. It is highly important. We need to understand what causes error, and we need to be able to control them effectively. I hope this was of help to you. This is the end of my lecture. Thank you for watching.